Dear Goenkans, today our topic is performing calculations. As you all can see on the screen, there is already a table in which data is filled. It was regarding our previous video. So today we'll perform calculation on this data only. Last time we entered specific marks for a few number of students. So today we'll see how we can perform calculations. You know, we can perform calculations in Excel in number of ways. Either we can write the formula, and we know formula consists of operators and numbers and cell addresses. So we can either get our formulas are also automatically inserted in Excel using a few functions, or we can just write the whole formula. There are many ways. So let's check out the first way. Say I want to calculate the Ali's total marks in 5 subjects. So I'll just write is equivalent to, then I can write sum. Sum means I am going to add them. Then I'll write colon bracket. Then I'll start the bracket and right click on the number and drag all the cells which I want to be calculated. Then I'll close this bracket and enter. I got the mark. So this is one way. The other way is where I want the result, I have to click on that cell and then I have to go on the formulas bar. Then I have here insert function option. Then I'll write sum. And see, here we'll all get, every time we'll get a description in this area. Sum adds all the numbers in a range of cells. So we'll write OK. And you already have a selected range, as you all can see in number 1, C5 to G5, and all the numbers that contain that are in the C5 to G5 are written here: 75, 69, 96, 56, 74. I just have to, what I have to do is, and even you got the result, that is add all the numbers in a range cell is equivalent to 370. By clicking on OK, this result will get displayed in the active cell. OK, and see, you got the result. Now we'll just check few more formulas. Insert function and see if I want this count. This count, what it will do is it will count the number of cells in a range that contains number. See, here we have 5 cells that contain number. So we'll click on OK. And now, what is the range? No, I don't want H. It has chosen a range, that is this H4 to H5. I don't want this. What I want is, I have to just write that. I'll write, I want these numbers to get calculated. So I'll just right click and drag until I reach to my last cell. So this is how we insert function. Then I'll write OK. See, 12. I got the result 12 because I have 12 number of students. As you all can see here, we have already roll number 12. So it means yes, it is right. We have 12 number of students. Let's see again another formula. So we'll just write is equivalent to, and then we can go in max. You know, returns the largest value in a set of values. So let's just see Hudad's marks and we'll see which is the subject in which he got the highest marks. So maximum will return the highest number of value. So I'll click on OK. Then I'll choose my range. No, I don't want what. When you have to choose the range, you just have to click on the first cell and then drag it to the last cell. See, the range is selected. I just have to click on enter. Yes, 95 is the marks which he got in SST. That is the highest marks which he has got. So this way you can perform a number of calculation in Excel. And even here we'll just write calculate the percentage formula. If you all know, the percentage formula is marks obtained divided by the total number of marks into 100. So our marks obtained is in H4 divided by 500, because 500 is not written anywhere, so I'm writing it myself, into 100. This is our percentage formula, 76. Now let's check using the Excel function. I'll just select a cell where I want the result, insert function, that then I'll just choose the function average. Okay, now I just have to choose the range. So it has already, this is the range. I'll just click on okay. So see, I got the percentage as 76. So this is the average. Now you don't have to each time, if you want all the students percentage, I'll just for copying the result we have to do control C, and then pasting it to another cell we have to do control V. But this will generate the result for different location, that is Fatima. Now if you want the percentage to be calculated for each and every student, what you have to do is you have to select these two cells on which you have already an applied formula, then drag it to the cell you want till you want the result. See, you know why these cells are blank, 000, because we don't have calculated their total marks yet. So we'll calculate them as well, and we'll get the percentage automatically because already a formula was applied there. Try to calculate few functions using this formula tab, or using your own functions, and try to perform these calculations on your Excel sheet. This was for today. Thank you.